What a marvellous sight for the New South Wales Rail Transport Museum, here in authentic premises in the former Enfield Loco Yard. This O-gauge model railway is the one which the Railway Department exhibited at the Royal Easter Show each year. Next day, Sunday the 28th of October. On this final day of the last Enfield extravaganza, 5910, seen here approaching Enfield from Canterbury, made four round trips to Sydney. In addition, 3526 made four round trips. And because of the high number of passengers wanting rides, 3801, intended to be the standby engine, made two round trips. In all, 12,567 tickets were issued. Line 10 crosses the turntable of the former number 3 roundhouse, demolished in September 1974. Beautifully restored portable and traction engines add to the splendour of this final big day at Enfield. To date, Thirlmere has been a fenced compound, tracks and little else. The Rail Transport Museum is always a fascinating place to visit, and on running days there is the bonus of steam-hauled passenger trains on the adjacent loop line. another running day, 3801 looks on while 5910 is in steam for loop line trains. On this occasion, 3801 provides the power for a trip from Sydney to Moss Vale via the main southern line, but on the return, it will swing on to the Picton-Mittagong loop line at Mittagong.
Thank you.
Our train has now joined the single-track Picton-Mittagong loop line, which was, by the way, the original main line. The Thirlmere Museum is unfortunately backlit in the late afternoon sun. However, we gain some idea of the extensive collection, at this stage still without cover. .3801 is being serviced, and we leave this tour to return another day when 3214 is heading south along the loop line from Thirlmere, bound initially for Goulburn. At Goulburn Loco Yard, the 32 has been coaled and now will be serviced. Thank you. We say farewell to the 70s and have a look at a steam extravaganza in the 90s. The trains hauled by the 36 and the 30 have been combined at Campbelltown. The extravaganza is not entirely steam. The vintage GM did its bit too on shuttle trips. Thank you. At the museum, 7921 is now back in New South Wales, having been in South Australia since shortly after the end of the Second World War. 3214 is the one we previously saw in maroon colour scheme. Thirlmere is normally a quiet little village, but roars into life on extravaganza days. So popular is the event that one year, so I am told by impeccable sources, this pub actually ran out of beer. Meanwhile, 3001 and 3801 have just returned from a trip to Picton. That was the last down train of the day returning to Thirlmere from Picton. The 1990 extravaganza draws to a close and the vintage buses head for home. Government and railway policy changes, including the ban on wooden carriages and massive increases in railway charges following the Cowan Bank collision on Sunday, the 6th of May 1990, will severely curtail the activities of all whale societies, including the museum. There will be no extravaganza for 1991. One train that has now been permitted to run has allowed a limited return of steam train operation to Thirlmere. While the 38 is being serviced, 5910 runs two shuttles to Buxton, with cars courtesy of 3801 Limited. Not quite an extravaganza, but nonetheless, the trains were eagerly filled. Thank you. blowing down the 59's boiler makes for some spectacular videotape. The train is the Rail Transport Museum's Yulefest Express. While most of the patrons partook of the gastronomic delight off-train, rail fans who remained on board were treated to views of the beautiful Canimbla Valley as the train proceeded to Clarence to turn on the balloon loop. In our final scene, the train is returning from Clarence to collect the now well-fed patrons.